You thought the joke ended with our location, but it's filled with balls!
Oh my goodness.
They knew everything.
Yeah, I'm beginning to think they knew.
You thought I was reaching. No. No, I was not.
Because, I mean, let's look at this. Why would... What would balls have to do with the situation otherwise?
And the big question here is, were these here before, or did the Goombas and such put them in?
Yeah, that's a good point. So, it's like, the Goombas
and a manic teddy bear on a beach bombs. This is Mario happening right now, and those things, those abominations of life.
I wish this had a sequel.
As I said, Super Mario Land 3 is officially Mario Land. And I should not have jumped up here. Because if I waited, I could have gotten the carrot.
I just realized that Wario Land is a sequel for this. But that's a spin-off.
Yeah, but it's literally in the game. The game is marketed and almost fully advertised as Super Mario Bros. 3 Wario Land.
You mean Super Mario Land 3?
Super Mario Land 3, yes, Wario Land.
But it's like Yoshi's Island, where is it part of the Mario series or is it the beginning of its own franchise? And people start coming to its own franchise.
Oh god!
Oh my goodness, it's awesome!
Okay, I just barely pressed on that, but yeah, this is in Mario's...
That's awesome, Voltron, as well!
This is in Voltron Mario's mouth.
It's an interesting... What?
Nothing! The thing is...
An interesting... And I've lost my train of thought.
Well, what have I done? Oh! Okay.
Oh, they explode?
Yeah, they explode at the end.
Oh, they're mines.
Yeah, they're mines.
That came out really fast.
Well... Honestly, considering where we are, would those be like the mouth pistols that you'd shoot in the giant kaiju battles?
Mouth pistols? I was thinking of plaque.
Their teeth are really white, you know?
Yeah, I guess.
But, yeah. So the latest kaiju battle, Mario needs this to be utilized. Why we don't use this robot to, you know, take back our castle, I will never know.
Because it's stuck. It's broken.
Yeah, well, why don't we spend time fixing it? And then Wario's just like,
no, that's Mario. Leon Switch is in his castle.
Oh, my nostril! Someone help me! Why does this even exist? Oh, this is moving much slower than the song. Ah, crap! I ruined all my eyeball part. Except I wouldn't be able to curse.
I don't know what you're saying.
Rental floss.
Okay. Oh, I'm assuming they did a song for Mario Land
2 and Mario Land.
Yeah, okay.
Really like that.
They did a Mario Land 2 part. Obviously, they did a Mario Land thing as well.
Out my mouth? That wasn't in the song, so I can't really say anything. And this is jerk placement. He thinks you're just gonna carry it all the way here, like, huh? Jerks!
That's great.
Well, it's not like I need the extra lives, but we're walking on Legos. We are unstoppable.
They're too big.
I guess, but this is very...
They're Roblox.
What I like to think is that no matter what the size, if you walk on any Lego, somebody could build like the biggest... What the fuck? The biggest Lego structure ever. Like the little... One of the nudges would be the size of a building. Someone would step on it and their foot would still start hurting them. Just from the mere fact that existentially it is a Lego.
With strong Lego. Or some really weak slob blades. Slob blades. Why did I say slob blades? So, well, you know when there's two words and they sound really similar?
Oh god, the three little pigs, they took over the robot.
That's random. But yeah, there's three words. Two words that sound really similar. I'm gonna stop. Trying to explain it is making me unable to explain it.
Yes, but the three little pigs over here have taken their home inside.
I like that they're coming out in order.
Yeah, well.
But this guy should be unstoppable.
Well, he jumps really high. You just have to wait. But technically, this is a boss that takes 9 hits.
No, that's, yeah. That's true.
But yeah, we've taken back our robot and the golden coin.
I guess this is where Donkey Kong Country gets its... bosses from.
No, Donkey Kong... the earlier Donkey Kong Country games had, apart from like the final bosses, usually had some decent hit... Well, okay, where have we been eating? Usually have some decent hit...
You just got pooped up because you got eaten by a turtle, but yeah, you're did. In underwater.
Yeah, we did.
So you just got
Yes.
You got pooped up.
Yes. Okay, it didn't count.
That's ridiculous.
But I completely forgot what I was saying before.
Decent hit ratio. It's not true, but
continue. You played Donkey Kong Country 3 for a while.
1 and 3, yes.
Yeah. I don't remember a lot of 1 because I didn't like 1. I remember the bosses in 2 having decent hits. It's just like you had to go through a pattern before you could get to the hits.
Big Belcho was fine.
Belcho was technically not even the amount of hits, because you can defeat him in I think 2 hits if you're fast enough.
I thought Belcho was like that barrel. Well, whatever.
I don't know the barrel's gender, and I won't be able to tell you. But yeah, so 3 has actually, the first 2, I'd say their hit ratio is around like 7-8, but Tropical Freeze now, I saw the first boss, like, this is the first boss, why are you jumping on it like around 12-13 times?
It's just ridiculous. I'm so glad for the super guy. Because I don't care about bosses. So when I went, because I would have never found out, because I
said, oh my god, you're so pathological, like, I don't care about bosses, which is why if I played a game and they had bosses, and even if they were the most fun bosses in the world, I don't care about them. If there's a way to skip them, I'd skip all of them.
If they're fun bosses, I mean, but, like, they're interesting
Minish,
enough.
Minish Cap has great. They're interesting enough, it's just that they go on for too long.
Yeah, like, the Mole Train that we both played in Returns 3D. That was awesome. But man, that went not so
for a
bad.
Second there, I was like, we both played? We did? Oh, yeah. But
yeah, it's just... Because I don't lose often enough. Well, yeah, I sometimes do. But my nephew, who has his own save file on Returns 3D, he found out that you can actually super guide the bosses. And I'm considering doing that because I just don't care.
You can kill things underwater by going on top of them.
That's awesome.
Except this is a maze.
Oh, that's awesome.
No! You're that during early Nintendo, apparently they while trying to make new games, they're like, okay, we'll start with the level design. And one person made simple level design, and one person made complicated level design. That was maze-like. One of those games became Mario, one of those games became Zelda.
Really?
Yeah. Apparently, that's what I've been told.
So they didn't have concepts, they just had level design.
No, I think they started out with a basic concept, but they were just like... We need specific things in the levels.
So it's just that Mario and Zelda came from the same group of people splitting off based on level design?
Yeah.
I like that theory. But yeah, I mean, if I'm playing a puzzle platformer, which is one of my favorite genres, I am playing it for the puzzle platform.
Except that
I am not playing it for 20 hit bosses.
If I'm skipping the boss,
that's just good. Goodbye, boss. No,
but it's part of the game. Somebody used blood, sweat, and tears to make Big Choo Choo.
That's true. Wait, are we talking about Big Choo Choo? We're talking about.
I was just
Minish
mentioning.
Cap?
Yeah, I just mentioned.
Big Choo Choo's awesome. The bosses in Minish Cap are fantastic. So I would agree. Yeah,
exactly. Minish Cap's bosses. I give bosses a chance, man.
Zelda bosses. Yeah, I usually have fun with Zelda bosses.
But the thing with this is that, in terms of, first off, I wonder what's going to happen. Like, if I ever
money.
Yeah, that's just 100 coins right there. If I ever. get Shadow of the Colossus. Like, if I find one of those game stores that don't know any better. And get Shadow of the Colossus, because there are a few out here. Then I'd make you play it. It's a game where it's just all bosses.
I know that much.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that at one point you try to throw the controller and jump it out the window, but I'd have a team specifically made to catch you and throw you back in. Oh man. We should play. The problem with Shadow of the Colossus commentating over it is that the parts waiting to get to the boss. I don't know how we're gonna handle that.
Oh, that's easy. We have a list of things to talk about, just random things, and then just roulette wheel. Whatever we're gonna talk about in this expanse.
Spin the wheel, and then somehow you get bankrupt. It's just like, who the hell put that up there? Why? And then in the second part is like, okay, we're spinning the revised wheel this time. Toothpaste, and then he's just like, you know, Colgate.
I would just commit to it. You are 100% right. I'm thinking that we'd spin the wheel. U.S. politics, nope. No. and then we're just silent for the entire part.
It's like comedy gold, relationship comedy, comedy gold. Oh, Chowder.
So we are inside Lord Jabu Jabu.
No, because Lord Jabu Jabu has cows inside him.
Well, only in Master Quest.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Huh.
He was uncomfortable, by the way. I liked that the temples were different. They should do that more.
Like, make two different versions of a Zelda game with slightly different stories.
No, I would hate that, no. But I mean, like, a re-release with
that'd
different...
Be like the new, that'd be the new millennium, where Zelda Ruby Zone, Sapphire kind of stuff.
Because, I mean, Pokemon and Fire Emblem, I don't want games I like buying suddenly making me have to buy them twice.
But you wouldn't need to, unless you wanted all the full story experience.
But I wouldn't want, and especially since, you know, I'm one of those lore people with Zelda, I would hate that lore split it too. And then suddenly, this is the, which one's real one? Oh, they both are! Oh,
imagine the 4chan conversations.
I don't browse V enough to know if they talk about this sort of thing, because I like being happy.
Happiness. Wait a minute, no you don't!
Oh yeah. Well, not to the I'm not unhappy to the point of liking to browse V.
Okay, sure, why not? Yeah,
I only go there to see the Fallout of stuff, like the VR Fallout, which is really funny.
Oh look, the minigame hut, which is secretly in the mountain that I don't care about.
Cool.
Bye.